Hi everyone, welcome back. So in this video, this is the second part of the previous video where we were talking about the cook model, schema model, and then recipe and then feedback, right? So there are three schema models we have created and there is a relationship we have defined. So here now we will see a little bit additional part, like how you can define the reference, and using that reference you can fetch the data. Okay, so we are actually creating the alias. And so if the situation is like this, there is a cook and there is a recipe. Every recipe is having one cook, right? So while getting the recipe, I also want to get the cook information in that. So we will actually define the APIs for that, and then we will try to get the cook information with the recipe. Okay, so recipe model belongs to cook, right? So this is a one-to-one relationship we are creating with recipe and cook. So here I'm putting alias that while fetching the cook from recipe, I will use the reference, cook reference, and the foreign key, I can explicitly define that foreign key I wanted to keep as a cook ID. Okay, and there is a one-to-many relationship between the recipe and the feedback. One recipe can have multiple feedback. So forget about the routes for now. Let's how we can bootstrap the data, I mean seed the data initially. So here you can see cook.bulk create. This is the first utility I'm executing. What it is doing, it's just creating the information about cook. Then I'm doing recipe.bulk create, or you can just do a create. So I'm creating only single recipe. Create will also work here because I'm not doing a bulk operation here. I need to specify the cook ID, the same ID you have specified in the relationship while defining between recipe and cook. So there is a cook ID. So I've defined cook ID is a one. So first I'm inserting all the cooks, and then for the first cook I'm just adding the recipe, right? Further it is the same way, and further I'm also creating the feedback for the recipe one. I'm just passing the recipe ID and I'm adding a particular feedback. So I'm actually seeding some data so that while running the APIs I should be able to get some data in response. So you can see I created one API, app recipe.findAll. So here this is a tricky part and you need to understand it clearly, because otherwise you will get some exceptions, error messages and all. Recipe.findAll, right? Recipe.findAll, what it accepts, it accepts all lot of argument. Find all where attribute one is this, attribute two is this. Okay, you can provide all different kind of conditions, attribute one greater than 50, less than equal to 45, or attribute three in one or two or three, attribute four, all these things. Or there you can write some conditions where attribute one greater than 50, attribute two less than 45, and attribute three in 1, 2, 3, right? All these conditions you can put, and even like multiple queries you can execute. So find all means I wanted to find all. I'm not putting any condition. What I'm putting is include. So whenever you are trying to get the recipe, also add, also give me the cook reference. I mean, whenever I'm getting the recipe, also give me the cook information. And here I have already created alias. So you should fetch the cook information for that particular recipe with the cook reference. And once you get the cook response, just send it in the response back. So let's try to seed the application. So you can see we have created all the tables. Now let's see the database first. So we can see that cook data has been bootstrapped with all this information. Here we have, I think, one recipe and two or one feedback, right? So you can see recipe has a cook ID, feedback has a recipe ID. All information is populated properly. Now, whenever you do the recipe.findAll, and I'm just trying to populate the cook information. So we have a reference of cook ID in the recipe, so I can just do this include operation, which will take care of populating the cook information with the recipe. So just application is up and running. You can see I'm able to get the cook reference, and the property here I'm putting the alias as a cook reference because I'm getting the model cook information as alias cook reference, right? So similarly, you can bootstrap the we have bootstrapped the feedbacks, right? So similarly, you can get the feedback information also, like I'm getting the recipe. You can just put something here. This recipe, I mean single recipe, it will try to get for you. I mean, for now, let's get everything. and in the recipe, recipe has one to many relations with the feedbacks, right? So what I want to populate the comments. I'm not sure as comments we are getting here. This is a reference and model is feedback, right? So what I'm trying to do is recipe, right? So in recipe, let's check the database. Recipe was having cook ID, so I was able to populate the data. So recipe was having cook ID. Now this relationship will not work here because I'm trying to get the feedbacks based on recipe. So recipe has the cook ID, so I am able to populate that feedbacks. So if there is a recipe ID, right? So I can do that based on the feedback. Feedback.findAll, and what it will do in the feedback, we have in the feedbacks we have recipe ID, so I can populate the recipe information from there. So feedback recipe model is a recipe as here it is tricky. I'm trying to get a recipe here. And as comments, right? Let's do this. I need to debug this first of all. I'll just try to keep just check this. So while you are getting not recipe, you are just actually getting the feedbacks here. So in the feedbacks, I'm trying to get all the feedback, and for every feedback, I'm including the recipe also. So recipe has a reference. Recipe has many feedbacks. So okay, let's try to check this one. I mean, when we try to drop the tables like this, which has a foreign key primary key relationship, your collection will drop. So the either way is you just delete the data or just set the foreign key check 0 and then enable the foreign key check, because directly you cannot delete the drop the tables which is having data and relationship there. So here all the data is there. I think I should get the MySQL exception, Sequelize eager exception. Yes, Sequelize eager loading error. So we'll try to also see what this, why this error comes, right? So let's try to read the message and we'll try to fix this in the next video. Recipe is not associated to the feedback. Okay, let's see. Recipe has many feedbacks. Okay, so in feedback has recipe. Okay, it is saying recipe is not associated to feedback. Okay, feedback dot find all model is recipe. Okay, so in feedback I have included the recipe. So I mean, I think I'm missing some arguments here. So let me debug this and we'll fix this in the next video.